shout health.
Cleanliness is key in extending the component life of your intensifier. We suggest that you wear a shop coat and gloves. We will be doing our maintenance on a 100 horsepower, 87K Hyperjet intensifier pump. Before doing any maintenance, make sure all your power is turned off. And turn off your water. The first thing we want to do is disconnect the inlet water. The next thing we want to do is disconnect the high pressure tubing. First unhook the sensor valve and then loosen the high pressure tube. Next thing we'll do is loosen the check valve outlet adapter. We will be using the loading tool to take off the end cap. Make sure you have read the manual for proper operation. Remove the boots, which are there to protect the threads. Then install the loading tool and be careful not to scratch the threads. Make sure that the step of the tool slides into the counter bore. Apply anti-seize to your threads. And install tool washers and nuts hand tight. Before tightening the loading tool, you need to attach the hand pump. Using a socket, going in a figure eight pattern, tighten the loading tool down. During disassembly, it is crucial that you back the nuts off one full revolution. You want to pump to 9,200 pounds. After coming to pressure, we want to loosen the nuts on the end cap in a figure eight pattern. Releasing the pressure, the tie rods will shrink. Remove the hand pump. And remove the tools, which should be relatively loose. Then remove the end cap. Then remove the high pressure cylinder and filler tube. Using two screwdrivers, we can remove the high pressure seal carrier. After cleaning, check your components for wear and replace if needed. We are going to install a new seal carrier. Before installing, clean the plunger. We are going to be installing the cylinder and the filler tube. It is possible to install this backwards, so make sure the cup side is facing this way. If this is a scheduled maintenance, do the check valve service, which is covered in another video. To install the check valve, apply food grade lube onto the O-ring. Install the check valve into the end cap, making sure that the orientation is correct. Install the end cap onto the tie rods. You may need to push up on the high pressure cylinder to get the end cap on. Apply antices to the threads, nuts, and washers, and install hand tight. Before tightening the tool nuts, we are going to attach the hand pump. This is different than the disassembly. We are now going to torque the tool nuts into a 20-foot-pound in a figure eight pattern. Now torque to 50 foot-pounds. Now close the valve and pump the hand pump to 9,200 pounds. Now torque the end cap nuts to 50 foot-pounds in a figure eight pattern. When torquing, you may notice a drop in pressure on the gauge. Do not pump it back up. Once you're done torquing, release the pressure on the hand pump. Now you can disconnect the hand pump and remove the tools from the end cap. Now torque the outlet adapter to 200 foot-pounds. Clean off your tie rods. And put the boots back on. Then we will reinstall the high pressure tubing. Put blue lubricant on the threads. And reinstall. Now reattach the cable to the sensor and the inlet water line. Follow the same procedures for the remaining high pressure seals. Then when